Hey guys, Jake from AV20 Media here. Today I'm going to be doing a comparison on GM's 2.7 liter L3B engine against the 5.3 liter V8. Now, the 2.7 liter inline four turbocharged L3B is the new standard engine on the Silverado and Sierra 1500 trucks. And the first upgrade option that you have from the 2.7 is moving up to the 5.3 liter V8. The upgrade costs about $1,800. And so as you're looking at newer Silverados, you might be wondering which one is best for you. There also is the option to upgrade to the 3.0 Duramax, but that is a slightly more expensive upgrade. We're gonna go ahead and save that for a different video and just stick to the 2.7 liter and the V8 here to talk about our traditional gasoline engines. Now, I did a video recently on problems and issues with the 2.7 L3B, and I think a few people that watched it thought that I was being a little bit more negative about that engine than I think I truly was being. So I wanted to go ahead and do this comparison video because I myself do own a 2023 Silverado. I opted for the 5.3 liter V8. But the 2.7 liter is still a very strong engine. There's a lot of pros to it. There just are also a few drawbacks and a few considerations that ultimately led me to get the V8 option of this engine. And so here in this video, we're gonna compare all of the things that I factored into this. We'll talk about reliability and common problems, performance, towing, fuel economy, and all those good things that you're gonna wanna know and consider when looking at buying a truck. So first off, let's go ahead and start about reliability and kind of compare a few key differences between these two engines and some things that I thought about from a reliability and overall cost of maintenance standpoint on these two engines. First off, the major problem on both of these engines has to do with the active and dynamic fuel systems that come with them. AFM and DFM have been wreaking havoc on GM's engines for decades now, yet they still put this technology into their engines to help them meet the EPA standards for fuel economy and emissions. The way the AFM and DFM systems work in the 2.7 liter and the V8 are very different. The V8 uses your traditional lifter setup, and the lifters are what actually cause AFM and DFM to operate. And so when you have a DFM problem on these newer vehicles, you ultimately end up with lifter failure. Now, the 2.7 liter doesn't have lifters. It uses a sliding camshaft system to where the camshaft actually moves and it has different lobes on it for AFM mode and non-AFM mode. There are still some problems arising with the AFM systems on these inline four 2.7 liter engines. So ultimately, that's the one big problem that I would look at with both of these engines when you're thinking about them. I will say that lifter failure on the 5.3 liter V8 is probably a bit more common than running into camshaft and AFM issues on the L3B. But with that being said, these are still newer engines. And in my opinion, it seems like the number of problems continue to rise. And so while I initially thought that, you know, AFM on these engines wasn't as much of a problem, we're starting to see a lot more people running into issues with the AFM system and even catastrophic engine failure. Moving on to my second thing from a reliability and kind of cost of ownership standpoint is direct injection. Both of these engines are direct injected, but the 2.7 liter is a turbocharged direct injected engine, whereas the 5.3 liter is naturally aspirated. Now, the reason direct injection is on my list here is because engines that run direct injection tend to have more common fuel system related issues with the high pressure fuel pump, with the fuel injectors, as well as with carbon buildup. The 5.3 liter V8 is gonna have some of those problems. There have been few cases of high pressure fuel pump failure and injector failure, and then they do experience carbon buildup as well. However, it doesn't happen anywhere near the rate that it tends to happen on the 2.7 liter, and that's because these engines are turbocharged. Because they're turbocharged, they operate at a lot higher temperatures and pressures, and their fuel systems operate at higher pressures as well, and so it tends to put more stress on the high pressure fuel pump, on the injectors, and because of those higher temperatures, you tend to build up carbon deposits a lot more quickly. And so on the 2.7 liter, we're already seeing cases of very bad carbon buildup within the 60 to 80,000 mile range. And the pre-2022 models had a ton of high pressure fuel pump failures. A lot of those have been fixed for 2022 plus. So ultimately, yes, they're both direct injected. However, the 2.7 liter is gonna have more problems with the fueling system because of the turbocharged nature. And then that brings me to my other point on this topic is, because it's a turbocharged engine, you're gonna run into a lot more problems at higher mileage levels. Once you start getting upwards of the 150,000 mile point, you're probably gonna start to experience issues with your injectors, maybe a high pressure fuel pump goes out. You'll definitely have pretty good carbon buildup that you'll wanna get cleaned. But in addition to that, because of the really hot temperatures and the higher pressures that these engines run under, you're gonna experience things like oil leaks that you're just not gonna get on a naturally aspirated V8 as frequently. And then of course, there's the issue with the turbocharger. Turbochargers don't typically last 300,000 miles. And so at some point, the turbochargers will likely go bad on these engines and need to be replaced as well. And then my third thing is gonna be the 8-speed versus the 10-speed transmission. Now, people didn't like what I had to say about the 8-speed not being a very good transmission. There were a ton of problems with the early model 8-speed transmissions from 2014 until 2019. Sometime along the way in 2020, 2021, they made some updates to these transmissions that fixed a lot of the problems that they have. And so the transmissions on the brand new and newer model vehicles are so much better than they used to be, but I still have a preference for the 10-speed, and I think a lot of drivers still have a preference for the 10-speed as well. However, some of that might just be a little bit of PTSD because of all the problems with the 8-speed. And now I know there was a recent recall done for all of the 10-speed transmissions, and everyone with an 8-speed likes to remind the people with the 10-speed about that, but that recall is a simple software update, and so it doesn't have anything to do with issues with the internal design of the transmission, which was the problem with the 8-speeds before all of the updates were made. However, I will say on a brand new 2024 or 2025 truck, it really is personal preference on whether you like the 8-speed or the 10-speed. There's not a whole lot of 8-speed owners that are still complaining about some of the shuttering and hard shifting that you used to get on them. But from time to time, you still do see some people that seem to think that they're having a few kind of quirky things that happen every once in a while. So ultimately, from a reliability standpoint, I say pick your poison. Both of them have problematic AFM and DFM systems. Outside of that, the only real consideration is that the 2.7 liter is gonna run into more problems just naturally once it gets to higher mileage because of the turbocharged nature versus the 5.3 liter being naturally aspirated. My ultimate preference here is to get the V8, go ahead and disable the DFM system on it. And ultimately, I think that's gonna lead to a more reliable truck. Part of the reason I say that is the 5.3 liter has been around for a lot longer period of time. And so it's been refined a lot more, and there's been a lot more small updates that have been made to it. Whereas the L3B is still a bit newer of a platform. All right guys, so that covers reliability. Let's go ahead and touch just briefly on towing and fuel economy. And then I'll talk a little bit about performance as well. So from a towing standpoint, towing wasn't a huge factor for me. The 5.3 liter V8 is going to be able to tow more. It has a maximum towing capacity of 11,300 pounds, and the L3B has 9,500 pounds. Now, both of those are with max towing configurations, which you need to make sure your truck has a max towing configuration for those numbers to be accurate. But ultimately, the 5.3 liter can tow more than the L3B, which isn't a huge surprise when we consider it's an inline four cylinder against a V8. With twice the displacement. So ultimately, towing's not a huge thing here. If you need to tow 10,000 plus pounds very frequently, then that's when I'd recommend going looking at getting a Duramax or a baby Duramax. Another big thing that I was talking about with the L3B that I think some people didn't like is gas mileage. The L3B only gets 19 miles per gallon combined, and the 5.3 liter V8 gets 18 miles per gallon combined. The L3B, for being a small four-cylinder engine, does not get fantastic fuel economy. Now, fuel economy does tend to be weighted a bit more heavily on the highway side of things. A lot of people are experiencing pretty good highway fuel economy with the L3Bs. They're just not getting good city. And that, in my opinion, is because of the turbocharged nature of these engines. And so you have poor city fuel economy, but you have decent highway economy. But a lot of people have complained because there have been a number of people that haven't been able to even get the combined 19 miles per gallon. So fuel economy, not a huge consideration in these two engines either. Just to put things into perspective, guys, 1 mile per gallon difference of fuel economy, if you drive 15,000 miles a year and 1 gallon of gas is $3, equates to a difference of $107 per year. So it's not a huge financial difference from a fuel economy standpoint if you do a reasonable amount of driving. I think a lot of the hate on the 2.7 liter here isn't that it's necessarily poor fuel economy, it's just that it's an inline four-cylinder engine. It has half the displacement and half the cylinders as a 5.3 liter. So everyone is like, why doesn't this small, you know, four banger get really good fuel economy? You know, look at Hondas and Toyotas that are running four bangers that are getting 30 plus miles per gallon. That brings us into our next topic right here, and that is performance. The big reason that the L3B doesn't have fantastic fuel economy is because it actually has very good performance considering it's a four cylinder that is only 2.7 liters. With the L3B, we get 310 horsepower and 430 torque. And so when we look at this from a fuel economy standpoint, you can't compare it to the Hondas and Toyotas that are out there with 160 horsepower and 180 torque. Of course, those things are gonna get better fuel economy. They don't have any power. The 2.7 liter L3B has really good power for being a small inline four cylinder engine. The V8, of course, gets 355 horsepower, so it has higher horsepower, but it actually has lower torque at 383 torque. So in my opinion, just from a factory configuration, the L3B is the stronger engine. And yes, it has less horsepower, but it has more torque, and it's half the size of the V8. But the other thing that we always like to look at and talk about with performance is not just what the numbers look like coming from the factory, because I promise you, whether you get the 2.7 or the V8, I don't think you're gonna be feeling like you're lacking power. And if you go from a 2.7 to the V8, I don't think you're gonna be like, wow, this thing just has so much more power. Part of that is because you have a lot more torque on the 2.7 liter, and so you feel like you have a lot more power and acceleration coming out of it because of that torque. And so both of these engines aren't gonna be a huge difference from the factory from a performance standpoint, but when it comes down to performance modifications, the L3B is gonna be a better engine than the 5.3 V8, and that's because of the turbocharged nature versus being naturally aspirated. On the L3B, we can drop a couple basic bolt-on modifications on there, like tuning, an exhaust, and an intake. Those three things probably cost you $1,000, maybe $1,200, and you can be adding over 100 wheel horsepower to these engines. And then of course on the 5.3 V8, it's naturally aspirated. So yes, you can do tuning and intake and an exhaust, but those things aren't gonna see anywhere close to 100 wheel horsepower power gains. To start seeing numbers like that, we're gonna have to start looking into more than just exhaust systems. We're gonna need headers. We're gonna need camshaft upgrades. We're gonna be needing to run E85 ethanol fueling. And at some point, you're gonna have to start looking into forced induction and some more advanced modifications. Ultimately, from a performance and a performance potential standpoint, I'd say the L3B is the winner here. So at the end of the day, which is better, the L3B or the 5.3 liter V8? Ultimately, it comes down to what you're looking for and what your preferences are. Yes, the V8 is a little bit more expensive, but it's not a huge price difference, especially if you're looking at financing a truck or buying one used. You can find ones at comparable price points. And so it comes down to what you're looking for, because there are good routes both ways. So ultimately, in a nutshell, I chose the 5.3 liter V8 because I think that it's gonna be a more reliable and durable engine over the long term, especially if you disable the DFM system on it. And in addition to that, I prefer the 10-speed transmission over the 8-speed. And there's also just something about having a V8 in a truck. So ultimately, the V8 was the right choice for me, but the L3B is still a great engine, and I think you'll be very happy if you think that that's the best route for you to go. Anyways, guys, that wraps up this video. If you appreciate the content, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for the future videos that we have coming on both of these engines.